Guess what?
Nope. No seconds. No seconds on the coffee. Only made enough for one round.
Well, how come?
Boss's orders. Running short of water.
Well, that's all you need. You can have some water out of my canteen.
Better hang on to it, Jim. You'll have to need every drop.
Well, all right, there's going to be water ahead.
Yeah, Pete's out looking for water, but I don't know. I figured on some rain, but you know, I ain't seen a cloud in days.
You know, in my village when we need water, it is the custom to hunt for a cacique bird. To catch one means to bring rain.
That kind of bird around here?
Oh, no. Only in the mountains, very high up.
Hey, here comes Pete down. What are you riding? Looks like he's caught something. You find any water?
Yeah, there's a creek up there. We'll hit it tomorrow.
Almost dry. Not enough to wet their gullets, I guess.
But that ain't all I saw.
Well, what else?
Well, it's a bunch of Apaches up there, only they're not like any Apaches we've ever seen before. They weren't red. They were green, maybe.
How do you know there's any green skins, Mr. Wishbone?
No, I mean they all had on fancy clothes like women's corsets and tight pants, you know, hats with plumes on them, and they had on those little old skinny swords. Listen, I'm telling you the truth. One of them even wore a...
One of them was wearing a what, Pete?
Well, he was wearing a... I guess it's an army uniform, but he didn't have any pants on. He had on a skirt. Well, he did. Listen.
Pete, why don't you take the afternoon off? Lie into the wagon there in the shade. Hey, you can raise the rations on him, can't you, Wish?
Yes, I don't need any more rations. I'm telling you the truth, Rowdy. They had on these scarves, red scarves, and white fluffy collars, and hoop skirts.
I've never seen it so quiet, Dan.
Say, eat. Even the beeves are feeling as much as we are.
Well, we ought to be able to make that creek by noon tomorrow.
And we'd better.
You feeling better, Pete?
I feel fine. Uh-huh. And I did see what I saw.
Sure.
Hey, that's no song to be a playing to a bunch of Texans. That's a Yankee song.
I was a Yankee once, remember?
Hey, which outfit did you fight with, anyway?
28th New York Cavalry. Any you boys ever run into us?
I'll tell you, Bert, if we had them, you wouldn't be here now.
Well, maybe you like this song better.
Well, now, that's better.
The music, the lovely, blessed music of my own native countryside, and I knew I must be among friends. I wonder if someone would be kind enough to fetch me a drink of water.
All right, give us an air. Here's some more. All right, that's enough. Easy.
My vanity case. Where's my vanity case?
It's right here, ma'am.
Well, thank you. I'm an actress by profession. And what's an actress without her vanity case? Without her paints and powders to help make her beautiful? This is all I have left. They took everything else.
They?
Those Indians. Those dreadful painted savages. It was horrible. I'm afraid I have no idea where I am, mister.
A favor, Gilfavor. We're driving a herd of beef north to Abilene. This is Rowdy Yates, Pete Nolan, Wishbone, our cook. You said they took everything, the Indians. What happened?
It was awful, Mr. Favor. I was on my way to Denver to fulfill a theatrical engagement. And then, all of a sudden, these savages attacked our stagecoach. They killed the driver and the man riding shotgun and the other two passengers. The only way I managed to save my life was by playing dead. After all, I am an actress. And then they just went crazy. They stole everything. All my beautiful costumes, my jewelry, all the accoutrements I use in my performances.
I guess we owe you an apology, Pete.
Yeah, I'd say you do.
If I hadn't been lying over my vanity case, they would have taken that, too.
Oh, well, ma'am, you don't need a vanity case or anything else like that.
Spoken like a true Southern gentleman, sir.
Ma'am, did you ever do any play acting around New York City?
What makes you ask?
Well, I thought maybe I'd seen you there once.
But I thought you were all from the South.
Well, we are, ma'am, except for him. And he even had the good sense to move to Texas.
Oh. My performances have been in the South, sir. I wonder if you gentlemen forgive me. I am rather tired and I'm hot and dirty. I wonder if there might be some way I might be able to bathe.
Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am, but we're running awfully low on water.
Oh, we'll be coming to that creek tomorrow, boss. Couldn't we spare enough for just a sponging?
I would consider it an act of great charity, Mr. Favor.
Well, enough for a sponge. All right, let's break it up. Let's give the lady some privacy.
Is something wrong, Mr. Favor?
I don't know much about play acting, but you do seem familiar somehow. I don't believe you told us your name.
Oh, didn't I? It's Pauline. Pauline Wakefield.
Miss Wakefield?
I got Mushy hanging some blankets over some ropes to make you kind of a boudoir map.
Why, thank you, Mr. Wishbone. If your cooking is as good as your manners, these men must eat like kings. Fire, soldier and afeard. And who would have thought the old man to have had so much blood in him?
Do you mark that?
Here's the smell of blood still. All the perfumes of Arabia could not sweeten this little hand.
Oh. What a sigh is there. The heart is sorely charged.
I would not have such a heart in my bosom for the dignity of the whole body.
To bed. To bed. To bed.
Mr. Wishbone,
what is a bosom?
$2, Maddox. You'll stay on and do my trick.
What's going on in camp is worth $2 to you.
A little entertainment.
I can use some after singing lullabies to beef for 4 hours.
Yeah, that's the way these two Jasper feel about it, too. Well, you get back to camp, give her a big hand for me, too. I had to leave right in the middle of her act.
Her?
Genuine her. Wait till you see her. You may not be able to make head or tails out of what she's saying, but boy, the way she's saying it.
All right. Just one more. What would you like? A love scene, perhaps?
Yeah.
Romeo and Juliet? Yeah. But I'll need someone to play Romeo. Why, Mr. Rowdy, you'd make a fine Romeo.
No, ma'am, I don't know none of them there talks.
Oh, you won't have to. All I need is someone to play to. Now, you just keep looking at me. That's all.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet. 'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. Oh, gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully. My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love is deep. The more I give to thee, the more I have. For both are infinite. That's where Romeo kisses Juliet.
He do? He does?
Good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night till it be morrow.
Hello, Pauline. What kind of men are you, paying court to her? Don't you know who she is? Don't you know Pauline Cushman when you see her? Don't you know the Yankee spy who brought death to your friends and kinfolk?
Is that true? Why did you lie to us?
Look at their faces, Mr. Favor. Do you think they would have welcomed me as they did if I'd told them? The war hasn't been over that long, and there are many of us that can't forget or forgive.
You bet they can't. Some got good reason not to.
You must have a mighty special reason.
Yeah. Mine's a special reason. You keep her away from me, Mr. Favor, or I'll kill her.
I lost a brother at Shelbyville. Rode right into an ambush, thanks to you. Guess they kind of gave you a medal for that, didn't they?
Oh, they did better than that. They commissioned her a major in the United States Army. Is there anyone here who hasn't lost someone on account of her? Or had someone hurt? Well, Mr. Favor, what are you going to do about her?
Just what did you want me to do about her?
Put her on a horse and let her ride out of here. She don't make it? Well, that's no worse than what's happened to the men she betrayed.
Now, wait a minute. I was a Yankee too once, remember? And there were spies on both sides and killing on both sides. She was just following orders, that was all.
Yeah, she did it real well. Maybe you've forgotten. Maybe you don't remember how well she did it.
I remember. Half my outfit was wiped out at Tullahoma. She set it up real well.
Well, Mr. Favor?
She'll ride with us to the next town.
That's 6 days from here. You asking us to share our water and grub? Our camps with this spy?
Look, the war is over. I don't blame you if you can't forget, but there does come some time for forgiving. And might as well start here.
Not with me, Mr. Favor. And I hope not with them.
Senor Favor's right. There was a time when my country and your country, we fought and we hated. It is better now since we have learned to forgive.
Wish, make a place in the supply wagon. And try to find some other clothes for her. All right, rest of you turn in. Get some sleep. We've got to hit that creek tomorrow before the sun dries it up.
Hey, I think you're making a mistake.
And what do you want to do? Leave her out here to die?
Mr. Favor, I do appreciate what you're doing for me.
I'm not doing it for you.
All right, if you come with me, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Wishbone. I'm most grateful for all your help.
I'm just following orders, ma'am. Just following orders.
I never figured his drive this fast.
rid of that spy. So now we're going to give him a choice. Her or us?
And just what do you plan on doing about it?
We're going to take your water, Wish. All your water. Come on, boys, hurry it up.
You don't think I'm going to stand by for this?
Don't try it, Wish.
This is an evil thing you do, senor. Those are your friends out there. Without water, they will die.
I don't like this any better than you do, Jesus. But Mr. Favor's not leaving us any choice.
You want that woman dead. Why don't you just put a bullet through her?
Yeah, I've been giving some thought to that. But the law would call that murder. And I already spent 2 years in prison on account of her. Now, when you catch up with the herd, you give Mr. Favor a message for us. You tell him we're going to keep pace with the drive. While we see him send that woman on her way, that's when we'll come back with the water. Not until...
Hey, come on, boys. Let's go.
That's what he said, boss. No water till they see her leave. Go after him, make a fight out of it.
Wouldn't do any good. Lose as many men as they would. We're already short-handed.
So what are we going to do? One thing for sure, we can't last without water.
Mr. Favor, I'm the one that they really want. Maybe if I were to ride out there and try to reason with them.
Well, they weren't in any mood for reasoning, ma'am.
Pete, if we veered to the east, how far is it to the nearest water hole?
Wet or dry? Well, it's 6 or 8 miles to the water hole, but I can't guarantee they'll have any water in it. I got a better idea. Why don't we do like they want and send that woman out of here?
Say, that's a real good idea for a brave man like you.
Now, wait a minute, Mr. Favor. You know yourself, ever since the first night that woman come into camp, we've been fighting a war. And it's getting to where it's darn near a shooting war. I say she goes.
Oh? Is that what you all want? Give in, send her out there to die? Because if you do, then the war never really ended. We can just go on fighting it forever. But just suppose that she was one of your own. She'd spied for you during the war. She was with Yankee drovers. You want them to turn her out? There's 100 miles of desert out there. She might last for about 6 hours. And then she'd die real hard and slow. But there's an easy way to do it if that's what you really want. We'd do as much for a dying horse or a steer. Now, which one of you wants to do it? You? Come on, you.
You made your point, Mr. Favor.
All right, we'll veer east. You got enough water to last till tomorrow. That's all you got to worry about.
Mr. Favor, you don't give up very easily, do you?
Sip of water, I've had more than I need.
No, I've had my share.
Pete?
Huh?
How much farther is it?
Well, it's a good 2 miles.
I'm up there laughing.
Driving the men crazy, boss, is that they're up there swilling that water, and we ain't hardly got none left.
Well, Silver, hang on. Ain't much further.
Looks like what might happen if that water holds you dry.
Still moving. Didn't think him to last this long.
Well, they can't last forever. Come on. Yeah.
I don't know.
All right, I want you to get down there and dig now. Pretend like there's water underneath and you're drinking from it. Come on, I said get down there and drink. Typhoon, I want you to pool all the canteens.
There isn't enough left for more than one or two.
Well, I'd fill them.
You heard what he said.
You see what they're doing?
It's like they're drinking.
Drinking what? Sand?
Here's all that's left. This one's full. This one's about three quarters.
So if it's enough.
For what?
Ours for theirs. Keep them drinking, Will.
All right, you heard him. Duck your heads in that good, cool water.
It's Mr. Faber. Like we've won. Stay here, Kirby. I'll see what he wants. You ready to meet our terms, Mr. Faber?
No. I come to give you mine.
You're talking mighty big for a man who's not holding any aces.
Well, if you're talking about water, we've got plenty back there.
You're bluffing, Mr. Faber.
Oh, am I? Does that look like I'm bluffing?
He's going out of his mind, he's pouring it out. And that's all we got left.
Like I said, we've got plenty of water. Water to waste. Still think I'm bluffing?
I know you are, Mr. Faber. See, we knew about that water hole, too. One of the boys rode up ahead and checked on it. Bone dry. Now you've used up all you had left, haven't you? You ready to send that woman on her way now?
No.
Figure to make it the rest of the way without water?
We have to.
And without the herd, too?
What do you mean by that?
Not something we want to do, Mr. Faber. But you're forcing us. Now, you've got till sundown to get rid of that woman. If you don't, we'll stampede the herd, and you know what that means. This heat, this desert, you'll lose just about all you got.
Crazy? What kind of a drover are you? That's your livelihood, mine, everybody else's. Destroy that, you'll be destroying yourself along with everybody else. Is that what you want?
No, Mr. Faber. What we want is Pauline Cushman.
It's gonna be dark soon. What do you plan on doing?
Yeah, sure.
Faber, why do you make it so hard on yourself? All you have to do is send me over there. Your problems are over.
What are you saying, Miss Cushman?
You know what I'm saying. Stop being noble. Stop making sacrifices for me. I've seen enough men die on my account. I don't want to see these men die, too.
No. Is that what you think I've been doing? Being noble?
Haven't you?
I've been trying to keep you alive. Do you think it's just for you? They're worth saving too, you know.
I know I've been a burden to you. I didn't realize how much of a one. I'll do anything you like. Just tell me what you want me to do.
Please, just keep out of the way. That's all I want. Just keep out of the way.
Well, we can always make a fight out of it.
With them?
Well, they're going to be stampeding that herd any time. You better make up your mind.
Make up our mind to what? Whether we kill her or not?
Mr. Favor!
Will you shut up, you lunk-eared chowderhead? Can't you see we're busy?
Miss Cushman, she's gone.
Gone? Gone where?
She just rode out. I seen her. See?
I don't get it. She knows how we feel about her, and we're the enemy. What's she trying to do, make it easy on us?
Maybe she didn't figure us to be the enemy.
She's not good. We should do something.
I'm for going after her.
So am I.
We can put up just as good a fight as they can.
Is that the way you all feel?
Yeah.
You learn mighty slow, but you learn good.
Well, what about it? Do we fight?
I don't think so. There's other ways besides fighting.
Like what?
Wish, how many barrels of our water they got out there?
Six.
Six. And how many would we need, rock bottom, to see us through?
We need at least three.
Three.
You win, Dan.
So they sent you out, huh?
That's right. They sent me out. What are you all waiting for? Mr. Favor said he'd take you all back. He needs the extra hands.
Oh, I'll bet he does. Let's get going. Dan? We just leave her here? With nothing? That was the general idea, wasn't it? Someone else is coming, Dan. Mr. Favor again. You didn't have to fetch us, Mr. Favor. We were just coming back.
I come for her.
No, Mr. Favor. No.
You sent her out to us, didn't you?
No, she came out here on her own.
Why?
To save our lives. And yours.
Why did you ride out here?
Does it really matter anymore?
Well, Mr. Favor, you can't have her. We're leaving her behind.
Out in this heat? Without any water? You want her to die real slow, huh?
Like she left our friends and kinfolk die.
Well, you better be ready to go the same way then. Dying real slow of heat and thirst.
Well, Mr. Favor, we've got six barrels of nice, cool, fresh water.
Do you now?
Mm-hmm.
Roddy!
Don't worry, the others are all still back there.
You figure to fight us with just one man?
I don't figure to fight you at all. Roddy's circled up above you there. He's got orders not to shoot anyone. Just the barrels. Now, you'd better make up your minds fast.
You're bluffing again, Mr. Favor. You lose us our water, that means you'll have none.
Oh, we had none anyway. Roddy!
I'll stop him.
Anybody tries to stop him, he's got orders to blast the rest of them fast. Now, it's up to you. You willing to lose your lives for the pleasure of taking hers?
Yes.
Roddy!
Stop it! Take her back. We don't want her.
Is that what you all want? You?
Yeah.
All right. I want your word. There'll be no trouble. You'll go back to your jobs and stick to them.
You got our word.
All right, Roddy.
Well, you ain't got my word, Mr. Favor. We brought her out here to kill her, and I say we do it.
Kirby, it's over.
Maybe for you, but not for me.
Why'd I do it, Mr. Favor? I hated her.
Did you?
Well, I should reach Lodestar by noon. You can get a coach out of there before dusk.
Thank you, Mr. Favor.
You, going back into play acting, ma'am?
That's all I know, Mr. Yates. I'm not very good at it, but I'll get by.
Well, there's other things besides acting, Miss Cushman.
Not for me, Mr. Favor. War's a cruel master. It brings people together and it tears them apart. It makes them love and it makes them hate. And when it's over, the scars are too deep. There's no way of going back to what might have been.
Well, don't just sit there. Take the lady into town.
Yes, sir, Mr. Richmond.
You ready, ma'am?
Depend on it. Myself, like me, a good wet strip of rawhide. Never let you down.
You got anything to say, you say it now. It's your right.
All right, Mr. Wagmaster. Well, now, that's downright surprising, seeing how you folks told this child flat out he didn't have the right to be alive.
You're wasting your time, Sanders. He's no more than an animal. You gotta treat him like one.
One thing. You sod busted me. Plow me under this day. Remember this. I'll let you do it. I'll let you play act out your big city trial. Give me 6 inches of steel that skin out every last son of you. Not even raising a sweat.
You'll raise a sweat at the end of this rope. Bring that horse.
Who's Tom, Mr. Favor? It was a good horse.
I sure didn't expect to see you, boy. Looks a real hunk of man to track down old Josh and these rocks.
Get your gear, we're moving out.
In the dark? What chance do you think you have against me out there where only my eyes can see? You better wait till sunup. That way the odds will even out some.
All right, that's a good idea. Well, we'll sunup.
Always did favor a sensible man. You got a nice chunk of meat over that fire. Smells good, doesn't it? No, sir, nothing like a nice fat meat, slow roasted. Sticks to your ribs. Well, go ahead, boy, what are you waiting for? Make sure you bite into that side away from the fire. Wouldn't want to burn your tongue out. Not yet, anyways. Don't thank me, boy. I'm just fattening you up for the kill.
Father.
Sarah, what's this Josh in him? Don't you pay no mind to the growls of an old man. Why don't you go fetch a little kindling? I'll keep you here company. That's it, boy. You got two choices. Well, either you hightail it out here right now, or you start digging yourself a grave.
The way I see it, you got the same two choices. You can either go out of here head first or feet first. It's up to you.
Too bad. Sure do hate to see a man cut off in his prime.
What about your daughter? You care about her, don't you? You won't do anything if you know it means losing her.
She'll be asleep, boy. She won't even know what happened. She'll wake up and you'll be gone. She'll be asleep, boy. She won't even know what happened. She'll wake up and you'll be gone. It's gonna be a long night, boy. I'd never yet seen a time that would not last a man staying awake. Anytime you decide to catch your winks, you're right ahead. I'll be right here, waiting to check you in. Nobody's gonna sleep tonight. You got spunk, boy. I like that. You might have made it all right in my time. I mean, a man could walk tall in them days. Him, sky, rocks. As far as the eye could see. There's room to swing around and holler up to heaven. Bring on your Blackfeet, your Manda, and your Sioux. I'll fight for my Uncle Mount. The devil take the horns. There's a man who can't stand tall don't deserve to live.
Father, you've got to understand those days. They're gone for good.
Maybe for some, but not for Josh Green. We're gonna live them days again. Gonna find me a mom. Just me, my girl. Sarah.
After Bridgesford, the law says you can go.
The law? up here, boy, a man his own law. Yeah, I'm not like the old days. White water, so thick with beaver, you pluck them out by the scruff of neck. And rendezvous time. You trade your plumes for gold and pretty trinkets, shiny beads, and for cloth the color of a rainbow, all for your woman. Rain whispering on leaves. That was your mother's name. It's a pretty name. Prettiest girl I've ever seen. Shoshone's always was fine looking women. She was more than that. She was gentle, soft, like a fawn that stepped out of the dark forest into the firelight. Proud day when I put my blanket around and made her my squaw. Rain whispering on leaves. You were a good girl, good wife, none better. Come down out of the snow. There you were in the lodge waiting for me. The fire to thaw out my bones and the smile to warm the child's black heart.
Sorry, Mr. Yates. I'm so sorry for everything. But please go on back while you still can.
I can't. I gotta take him back. Help me take him back, will you, Sarah? For his own good, it's his own chance.
Help you? I can't even help myself. He expects me to be like her. My mother. A silent little maiden who worships him. Who tends his lodge, who skins his hides, cooks his meat.
It's just a mountain wolf. He won't come around here with a fire.
Well, I keep telling myself that I don't believe it. And I never will. My life is made up of four walls, Mr. Yates. Four walls around a feather bed, books, music. Where people laugh and where mountain wolves exist only in bad dreams, soon forgotten. Ever since he left your camp, I knew that no amount of pretending to be the ideal Indian daughter could ever change what I am or what he is.
Yeah. Now you gotta stop running before it's too late for both of you.
I can't stop an avalanche. Neither can you. You better get some sleep. You'll need it.
This long if I didn't have Sarah with me. All that's keeping you alive, boy.
Well, you better wake her up. I want to get started over that mountain.
Bad country, boy.
Well, we saved 10 miles that way. Pick up the herd this side of Bridges Ford.
Long way to Bridges Ford. Long way. Hard things can happen to a man on a mountain trail like that.
What are you scared about going back for, huh?
But I told my girls the truth.
Why don't you show her the truth instead of just telling her? If you're innocent, the law will protect you.
I don't need no law to protect me. I've been doing it myself for almost 50 years. Like I said, a man's his own law up on them rocks.
Well, things have changed. Things are a lot different now. I remember a few years ago, there was a kid with our outfit who was shot in the back at some Red Dog saloon. The killer disappeared, and all we could do is put a daisy in his hand and plant him in the ground. Things are a lot different now. You didn't kill Thomas's boy, the law will free you.
I don't need no judge and jury to tell me whether I go free or not. I was born free. I am free. And that's the end of it.
Oh, what about Sarah? You gonna let her go through the rest of her life being hunted like an animal?
Now, look, boy, I'm telling you for the last time. You leave Sarah and me alone. Now, get on a horse and put this mount by you and don't never look back.
I give my word and you're going back.
Well, I guess that tears the rag off the bush. One of us is going to die, boy. Just as sure as night follows day, one of us is going to die. Here for your night camp.
Permission on.
You go up here to your horses, boy.
All right, for rest.
There. This is one tired little girl. Too bad she can't lie down for a spell.
I didn't say she couldn't lie down.
I'll build a fire.
Rest. 1 hour, no longer.
Why don't you catch yourself a little nap, boy? Just close your eyes and your troubles will be all over.
Hey, do they hungry? Hey, do ma buffalo horn? Why, you old cross-eyed bandit? Hey, hi, get off.
Look at you. You're skinnier and uglier than ever. This old Kiowa bandit was the bloodthirstiest murderer I ever fought with. Of course, that was more than 30 years ago. We're friends now. Ain't we, you miserable old horse-stealing murderer? Venga. Dokado.
Oh, Kime, Amahku.
The power of friendship.
He didn't give the rifle back.
Be grateful, boy. Old Josh wasn't long. You'd be missing a hunk of hay by now. Easy, boy. Let him look around. Buffalo Horn wants to be sure there's nothing to steal that'd be worth breaking up a friendship over.
They don't die. Same art. They pile.
It wants Polly.
Hey, Pato. Trouble, boy. Them brands in your horses. We get you from a fair-sized trail herd. The Bermuda of a trail herd would be worth breaking up any friendship over.
He's sure ridden a lot to a brand, ain't he?
Well, he ain't no village fool, boy. The chief.
I notice your old friend gave you the rifle back.
That's right. My old friend decided to camp out on that ridge above us. And tomorrow he's going to shadow you all the way back to your herd. Looks like you're going to have to lead him away from Bridger's Ford. That is, if you want to save him.
Well, who's to say we're going to be here in the morning anyway?
Don't try moving out. You can't see them, but they can see you all right. Be a pair of eyes watching us all the time. Might as well stretch out your bones, boy. It's going to be a long night. Just about the worst thing. Stand quiet. Don't even blink.
The Hardesol ain't the Hothail ain't the Gulp.
What a chicken boy, you ain't go out.
Eba, Baga, Bobahi.
Ain't gonna be easy to smooth down his tail feathers. It was his favorite son you just laid out.
Your daughter's asleep now, Green. It's just you and me, you can stop giving me those lies.
Last man who said something like I told Josh is still hanging head down over a slow fire.
And Buffalo Horn didn't read anything into those brands you told him. You cut him on our herd.
That's the way you got figured, huh, boy?
That's right, just like that farmer had figured, an eye for an eye. And if he got in the middle, the great Jess Green would bury him shallow and walks on that grave, right?
Yeah. You know. You know it all. Everything. Got the whole life all figured out, down to the last beat here, huh? You don't know nothing, boy. Not nothing. You ain't lived, boy, till you walk this mountain, till you breathe this air, till you lie on this earth. This is the only kind of life, boy. That's the kind of life they killed. Kind of life they took away from me. Man can't follow the beaver no more. The beaver gone. They keep coming mile after mile of them in covered wagons.
Hatchet-faced sodbusters that slob over the land. Grip, quarreling, psalm-singing hypocrites. Call you a squaw man because you took a Shoshone wife. Call you a daughter a half-breed. Like there's cutting of a whip. And these are the kind of good people I had to tip my hat to make a living for my daughter. Belly crawling scalp, that's all I could do. I wanted a free man more. Yeah, I sick them cows under your herd.
Father, you can't mean that.
Why not? Them cowpush don't mean nothing to me. Besides, the way it stands now, it's either them or us. What do you want to do that for?
My shoulder.
Just it's chewed up a bit. Hardly more than heavy itch.
I had to do it. I couldn't.
I know, girl. I know. But don't you pine on it, girl. Don't ever pine on something you had to do. You're right, you know. Just like your ma. She let go of me once with an old muzzle loader to keep me from slicing up some no good French. It's a good thing that old cannon misfired. Yates, appears to me I got a few fences to mend. Get the horses. Help me, girl. Oh, now, never mind about that. Something I got. I've been saving this for years. Time I'll be to have it. Your mother gave it to me. It's a Shoshone medicine charm. It's the one you love.
Yeah. Hmm.
Well, you tried, Mushy. Bless you, you tried. Maybe you'd better go wash pots now, huh?
Well, much obliged, Mr. Faber. Mr. Quince, Mr. Scarlett. I didn't know you cared whether I eat or not. Much obliged.
How come Mushy's doing the cooking?
Oh, we're just having a little fun with Wishbone. I told him I found a horseshoe nail in that slum gullion he made last night. Well, he jerked his apron off, flung it at Mushy, and it just stunk off.
You think maybe you're riding a little bit hard? You know, he ain't 20 years old no more.
Well, now, if he's too old for the job, maybe he hadn't ought to be out doing it. Yeah.
Ribby.
That's a good girl, Emily. You just stay there. I'll be through in a minute.
What are you up to?
If you absolutely got no, Emily isn't laying like she ought.
So you're feeding her salt?
I'm not feeding, I'm sprinkling. Don't you know anything about chickens at all? A laying hen in a ring of salt, an egg a day without a halt. Thought everybody knew that.
I heard of it, but I always kind of suspicioned that it was just a silly superstition.
Are you calling me superstitious?
Oh, Wish, all
well,
I said...
Well, I'm not.
All right. Look, Wish, what's wrong?
How many times I gotta tell you, Emily isn't laying.
I'm not talking about the chicken. I'm talking about you and the men.
What about me and the men?
Time was, I looked up to you, respected you. What's happening?
Well, I'm fed up, that's all. You try to do a little extra for them, what do you get? There's too much salt. There's too much pepper. There's not enough pepper. You call that coffee? I thought it was something to take off tattoos with.
Yeah, that's just joking, Wish. Shows they like you.
Shows they don't care. Not one of them. Time was I used to get up 2-3 o'clock in the morning just to bake so they'd have a nice bed instead of hardtack. Well, I'd sure hate to stand still till one of them said thanks. Why, I'd take root and flower like a Green Bay tree.
Thanks, just a word, Wade.
Well, I'm glad you told me. I thought it was a bird. Now look what you've done. Tisn't bad enough that you had to start the drive on a Friday when everybody knows that's the worst luck of all. Now you've gone and made me knock over salt.
Will you forget about the salt we're talking? Now, it's hard enough pushing a drive without having trouble amongst the men, and I got no room for prima donnas.
Prima donna? Would you like to break that down into American?
Yeah. That is a cantankerous old snapping turtle who suddenly got it into his head that the whole world's against him.
All right. They'll get their 3 squares a day. But if you think I'm going to be Little Miss Sunshine for that bunch of saddle tramps, you got another thing coming.
All right, I'll settle 3 meals a day and try to get along with the men.
Will you? I'll do my best.
You just do that. Huh?
Mr. Faber. Oh, Mr. Faber.
What's that?
That's what it looks like. Gypsy.
A gypsy on the drive.
Remember what you promised?
All right.
What can I do for you, Mr. Zagorny?
Don't call me Laszlo. Look, the mayor, she's perfect. For $10. Naturally, we'll accept my personal note.
I hate to cut the answer short, but
no.
Oh, there's Wishbone, a cook.
Ah, the cook. You know about you, paprikas.
Were you who? Never heard of him. What outfit's he work for?
It's not him. It's food for angels. Boryu paprikas with cipetke. Delicious. Now, I'm looking forward to many happy hours teaching you my native dishes.
Well, you can look forward to a ladle for a hat if I catch you near my chuck wagon. I know your kind. You'd steal a hot stove and come back for the smoke. Boryu pish posh.
No Boryu paprikas. Tragedy.
Emily. 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 Thank you.
Emily? Emily? Emily?
Mr. Favor, if that dirty robber goes, you just lost a cook.
Oh, my chicken. A burger chip.
It looks like the show's over.
My lovely chicken. My beautiful burger chicken.
Forget the chicken.
Forget the chicken. My heart is on the ground, squashed like an old dumpling, and you forget the chicken. I've raised a monster.
Papa, stop it. Did you hear what the man just said?
Yes. He called your father an old tub of goulash and a robber. And you're a big, strong, healthy girl. What do? You stand there and do nothing.
He said, we go or he goes.
What do I care what he said? He says, we go or he goes?
But I don't think Mr. Favor would send us away. Not if we told him the truth.
No, that's a chance we can't afford to take.
Maybe if we gave...
Please, your pa is thinking. He said, we go or he goes. Simple. He goes. He goes. Delicious.
Perhaps even politics.
Truly a man among men.
I am.
All right.
Rowdy, now's your turn.
I see a dark-headed woman.
Money.
More money. Long life. 5 children, all yours.
Anyway, the part about the dark-haired woman sounds good.
All right, who's next? You. Here's my friend.
Well, come on, Mr. Wishbone.
You don't think I'd let him tell my fortune, do you? Besides, it's just a bunch of folder all.
Of course, if you're afraid.
Afraid? Who's afraid? Not afraid of anything you could tell me, you big tub of goulash. Go ahead, tell.
First, we'll read the cards.
Anybody who listens to this kind of foolishness has got poached eggs for brains.
Ah, I see you're a leader. Brilliant, able, intelligent.
Well, sometimes these fellows hit it a lot closer than you'd think. What else do you see?
I see money.
I always figured someday I'd hit it big.
Here, now you take a card.
Wait a minute. I'm getting a picture. I see gold. Round, flat, a gold piece, a $20 gold piece. You'll find it in an old boot.
Well, that ought to be easy to find. I only got one pair of old boots, and that's right over here in my duffel bag.
Wait, wait. There's more.
More?
Here, take another card.
There you are, ace of spades.
No, I'm sorry, it's a mistake. Here, pick another card.
Well, that's the card I picked. What's it say?
You don't understand, my friend. The ace of spades is the worst card in the deck. It's the death card.
Death card?
I'm sure that this time... Two mistakes in a row. It's rare, but it does happen. Don't be discouraged. Find the right card. Here, choose a card. Come on, choose a card.
I'm choosing. Don't rush me.
I'm sorry, my friend. Three mistakes.
You mean, good thing I'm not superstitious.
I'm sorry, my friends, fortune telling is finished.
Now that I have danced for you, perhaps you will return the compliment. We could start with the story of your life.
Yeah, well, that might not be too interesting. Sure be long.
I don't suppose you could be mistaken about this.
Wait. I see a picture. A lonesome grave and a prairie. There's a cross. The name of the cross is Wishbone. We are no mourners.
No mourners? Nobody? Well, that just goes to show how wrong you are. I've been with some of these fellows for years. Mr. Favor, Rowdy, and Jesus, Quince, Scarlet. Why, if I was to kick off, every one of them would be there. Every one.
No one.
Mr. Wishbone! Mr. Wishbone! Bring your duffel bag.
What for?
For that $20 gold piece in your boot.
That's right. That's right. You said I'd find a $20 gold piece, didn't you? Well, that was part of the fortune, wasn't it? Well, I'm just going to show you there isn't any $20 gold piece in my boot, and that'll mean the rest of your fortune is...
I didn't believe in fortune, Tom.
There's one way to escape your fate. Leave the herd.
Leave the herd?
Immediately. It's your one chance. The cards are spoken.
Escape your fate and leave the herd. What's he mean, Mr. Wishbone?
He's trying to give me hope, Mushy. Hope where there isn't any hope.
What do you mean, Mr. Wishbone?
I'm doomed, Mushy. I should have known it yesterday when I saw those three buzzards. When I spilled that salt. This just about nails the lid on it. I'm a goner, Mushy.
I'm sorry about what happened. I hope you are not hurt.
Suppose I could survive a certain amount of pampering. Plays that thing pretty good, doesn't he?
Ah, all the old jitties do.
The new ones don't?
Some of us. I don't know. Papa says we are not proper gypsies. One, my cousin Christy. He lives in a house. To you, this means nothing. You like living with the consolation for a ceiling.
And you don't?
What woman does?
I always thought one got along real good with starlight moonbeams. Violin playing.
A romance, yes. A living, no. Wheels made for rolling, not for building a future.
Or a family.
Or a family.
We'll move up on ahead of them.
What about the fence?
I think we'll need it. We'll hit them tonight late. If that don't help, we'll drive that herd back on their throat tomorrow.
Abide with me, fast falls the eventide, the darkness deepens, Lord, with me.
I saw that! No, you just put that back there, Roddy.
I mean, you just keep that cookie, Roddy, and enjoy it. But don't spoil your supper, because it's going to be a good one.
Abide with me.
I swear. What are you eating there, Rudd?
Cookies. Wishbone baked them.
Baked? Something sure got into that old coot.
Well, what do you see, chow? Ribs, beef, sweet corn, mashed potatoes. It's everything.
How about that? Beef tonight, hot meal for noon, and then breakfast this morning.
I don't know. Maybe he's seen the light and heard the horn.
He even unsaddled my horse today. He said I looked tired.
Maybe his fortune has him worried.
Well, he ought to be worried. Oh, boy, I never see that death card come up three times in a row.
What's the matter with you, Senor Jim? The black ace? That was only a joke.
There ain't nothing funny about that black ace.
But that's only a trick. I've seen it done many times.
A trick?
Wishbone sure don't think so.
So you don't think he's got a notion he's cashing in?
Seems kind of strange. You know, I was over there. He was teaching Mushy the words to abide with me.
Maybe Chet's going to pick up around here.
Wait a minute. We can't go around letting the old boy think he's going to die. We got to tell him about it.
Well, it'd be a shame to spoil that good mood before Chow, anyway.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Al. Okay, we'll tell him after Chow.
I've got another beef rib, Quince. Scarlet?
Oh, I'm busting, Wish.
Mr. Favor, anything more for you?
Up to here.
Plenty of everything, Rowdy.
Could you eat another bite, Wish?
You fellas?
Not for a condemned man. Wish your cook's a mean last meal.
Mm. What do you mean?
Did you come? A gypsy told him a fake fortune. He thinks he's a goner.
What kind of a joke is that?
Well, we're going to tell him about it after chat.
There you are. Plenty here. Anybody else? Anything at all? There's plenty of biscuits and lots of that good red gravy for sopping.
It's after chow right now. Wish?
Did you change mine, Mr. Favor?
Oh, thanks. I'm full. It's beautiful. I'm full up. Look, Wish, there's something I want to talk to you about.
Oh, well, first, Mr. Favor, there's something I'd like to say to everybody. I don't want this to be a shock to anybody, but your old friend Wishbone isn't going to be with you much longer. So I wrote up the will this afternoon.
There, Jim, don't cry. It isn't as bad as all that.
those of you that haven't guessed, I'm a goner. The pearl gates are open and wide. Now, wait a minute, you don't understand. I'm cashing in. That's fun.
Wish you're not gonna die. It's just a joke. A bad joke, maybe, but you're not gonna die.
Now, tell him.
It was a joke. Harmless joke.
And y'all just let me go ahead and make a fool of myself.
Now, hold on. Wish.
Leave him be. Listen to this. I left will and testament. I ain't got much. Thought the best thing's a $20 gold piece. That's for Mushy. Might be able to buy him a little schooling. As far as the drive share is concerned, that's for a good time for all of you at the end of the drive. And don't sit around feeling bad about old Wish. Had a good life and some good friends. Man can't ask for much more. I'd like Scott to have my new boots. And Quinch, take my pipe. You had your eye on it long enough. Toothless, I want you to have those trained dice of mine. The only way you stay ahead of the game. But the rest of my gear ain't much. If anybody would like to have a keepsake, I'd be proud if you'd help yourself. That's about it. But I'd like to see this. I believe in God. If he's better to me than an ornery old man deserves, I'll be someplace watching out for you. All of you. Always your friend Wishbone.
Lo siento, señor Fair. I would have stopped you, but I did not know.
Well, which way did he go?
Quien sabe, I paid no attention. Shall I sell your horses?
Oh, well, an hour's a start. He could have gone anywhere.
Oh, I'm sure he'll come back, senores.
He'll come back. He's got nowhere else to go.
It's Favor.
Yeah, what is it?
A letter coming in from North.
See, I told you he'd come back.
Wishbones.
Where'd you get it?
He was heading toward Heber when we picked him up.
Anything's happened to him? Anything at all?
He's all right. There's no reason he shouldn't stay that way. Provided one thing.
What's that?
Well, Sam says, and I want to make sure you get this right. Sam says you got exactly 1 hour to come up with the woman and the $500. If you don't, you can start looking for a new cook.
What are you talking about, killing?
Say it like a prayer, cowboy. Say it and believe it. 1 hour. And when you come, come nice. Understand? Understand.
Yeah, we understand. All right, take it easy. Y'all get a chance to talk at one at a time. Good.
The man's got Wishbone. I don't see there's anything to talk about. Let's go get him back.
Yeah, swell. That's a great way to get Wishbone knocked off right now.
Well, Mr. Favor, right, they'd kill him, sure.
Well, if that's so, we got no choice at all. We got to do what they say.
Live girl against dead man? I say she goes, and the money, too.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. That's not possible. In the first place, I haven't got the money. I swear it, my honor.
What honor?
No, he is telling the truth. I looked in the wagon. There is no money.
Wait a minute. You've got $500, don't you?
There's a little over $500 in trail expense money.
I got $60 owed me on this drive, and I just quit. It goes in the pot.
Double it.
I'm in. Anyone else for drawing her time? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Big
All right,
relax. Nobody's got it all their time. You got the $500.
Cowards. Cowards. What about my daughter? Are you willing to turn her over to that monster? Where's your sense of shame? Where's your manhood? We must fight, attack, charge. Show them no mercy.
Yeah, and get Wishbone killed?
You can't make an audit without breaking a few legs. Now, men, listen to me. All of you. You all have daughters, mothers, sisters. It is your sacred heritage to protect womanhood. Now, you have men, you have horses, you have guns. All you need is a leader. And I, as the world's foremost...
Harper! Shut up. You're the world's foremost windbag. And you know it.
My own daughter talks to me like that. What have I raised? A monster, an animal. A turnip without a heart.
Papa, stop it. I can be ready in 5 minutes.
You're not going to see yourself with that beast.
You are the one who sold me, Papa. I am just living up to your bargain.
They finally coughed up, huh?
Well, the crew chipped in.
Well, is it all there?
Yep.
All 500?
Yep.
Well, what was that for?
For trying to buy me in the first place. If you want a woman, you ask the woman. Now, I am ready to keep a bargain. We'll take the wagon. It's a long way back to Heber.
My little girl, I'm going to miss you.
Papa, you get in the back. Sam will drive.
Oh, my frail angel.
Are we taking him?
He is my father, and he's your father-in-law. And don't you forget it. Besides, he's a good cook.
Any other comments?
And take that cigar out of your mouth. It's too hard to clean. Now, that's better. Please, your arm.
Yes, dear.
Come on, move along, move along.
Gotta get this line moving,
Dave. Look at him. Just like yesterday never happened. Wishbone's will, the men shell out the 500. No one even mentioned that.
Ain't no need to.
Well, come on, what are you doing? Dreaming?
Oh, he finally broke down and made fresh bread.
Well, it's about time.
Oh, very funny. Come on, move on. Act like a bunch of old ladies.
sure can't argue with their taste.
Will you be on the trail long?
Till Sedalia, Missouri.
And then what?
Almost forgotten what my little girls look like.
That isn't right.
No, it isn't.
I told you this was dangerous country.
Well, I don't think it's dangerous.
I come out to play Ring Around the Rosie.
So formal, I'd have put on my Sunday spurs.
Question is, what are they being so formal about?
Seems like a bunch of yearlings, don't they?
I swear not one of them over 20.
That's what's protecting our frontier these days. This frontier's in trouble.
Wish don't close up shop. They may be hungry. It's always good to meet the army halfway.
Sergeant Madsen, Sea Troop, 4th United States Cavalry. 3 days out of Fort Flag.
Gil Favor, trail boss, and I don't know how many days out of San Antonio. Hey, your men look tired.
Men? You're mighty kind, Mr. Favor.
Maybe they could use a hot meal?
We have our own rations, mister.
Corporal, we're accepting Mr. Favor's invitation.
Yes, sir.
What's wrong, Mr. Wishbone?
What's wrong is Mr. Favor's just invited the whole United States Cavalry to breakfast. I think you might ask us first.
Well, would we have said no?
We mighty well might have. Known that.
Detail, prepare to dismount!
Prepare to dismount!
Prepare to dismount!
Oh.
Dismount!
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 Oh.
Dismissed.
Dismissed!
Corporal, run a picket line.
Yes, sir.
Take my horse.
Say, we got some fresh water stream back to camp.
Makes you think I got water in this.
You in the war, Mr. Favor?
That's right.
Officer?
Uh-huh.
How would you feel about leading a detachment like mine?
Oh, a bunch of foot-and-mouth greenhorns like that. Thanks, but no thanks.
It kind of helps me forget how green they are and what can happen to them out here. You know how old my corporal is? 19. He's the oldest. The rest of them, well, in a year or two, I'm going to have to get him out of shape.
Never seen a company that young. Towards the end of the war, a lot of kids were joining up, but...
Sounds as if you'd been fighting for the South. Well, I better go make sure my veterans watch behind their ears.
Didn't you never see a sergeant before?
The army was crawling with him.
Wasn't they all?
Thing is, I've seen that sergeant before, only...
Yeah?
Well, he wasn't a sergeant then. His name wasn't Matson.
It's Matson
now. No. That ain't the name I don't remember.
It ain't?
No. Well, it ain't important.
Seem to be very much of it.
No. You know, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
that.
That's fine, thank you.
But drovers ain't a lot. Hey, he's a growing boy, Mr. Wishbone.
Growing into what, an elephant? All right, keep the line moving. Come right on with it.
Maybe you'd better get started now, Mr. Hoyt. 3,000 still raised a lot of dust. Might be smarter to be riding ahead of the herd.
Might be smarter if we went off in a totally different direction.
But Nelson, we're going the same way.
Could be our first mistake.
Not really.
Get it.
Well, I guess we won't be seeing you anymore. Well, that's not a very good guess, Mr. Taylor. Sea troops courting you through the danger area. Orders have killed Merriweather, Fort Flag.
Oh, what danger area?
Canyon. 2.5 miles through, 25 miles around. Figures you'll take the canyon way. Save 3 days.
The canyon's that narrow, we'd lose more beef trying to squeeze them through than be worth the time saved.
Well, you might lose them anyway.
To what?
Raiders.
What kind of raiders?
We find out, you find out.
What does that mean?
I don't know, Mr. Faber. Just don't know.
And, good would your veteran be?
I've got my orders. And they'll fight, I think.
Sergeant Matson, we've got no orders about escorting any cattle drive.
25 drovers, 25 men. Corporal, did you ever fire a gun at the men that fired back at you?
No, sir.
Neither did they.
What difference does that make, sir?
Spoiler's aim. Don't call me sir.
But we got no right to get the drovers mixed up in our...
Corporal, I'm Army. I've been Army a long time. They give me a job to do, I do it. Any way I can.
Yes, sir, except I...
Accept nothing, and don't call me sir.
Might mean we'll miss your father's ranch.
That's what I thought.
Well, this is goodbye, then.
Well, if it was all right with you, I'd ride along with you to the ranch.
Would you?
Why wouldn't he?
I understand there's raiders operating in this area.
That's one of the reasons I want to ride along with you.
You follow Mr. Faber, Nelson, will you?
You giving me a choice?
Follow him, yes.
They're out.
Looks like the high man's coming to visit.
Yeah, neither one leg's short or another, or else he's been drinking something besides coffee.
Mr. Faber back yet, gentlemen?
No, he's gonna catch up to us.
Well, the only route going to be through the canyon.
Yeah, that's right, except we ain't going through the canyon.
Of course you are. Mr. Faber tell you before he left?
No, he didn't.
I guess he forgot it.
Mr. Faber, don't forget things like that.
You call me a liar?
No, I'm not calling you a liar.
And the herd goes through the canyon.
Rod is in charge. Mr. Faber's away. He'll decide that.
And you'll follow Mr. Faber's orders.
Yeah, I will. And he gives them to me.
What's your name?
Jim Quince.
Mind if I talk to you alone?
I was just leaving.
You've been watching me ever since morning. When?
Well, I ain't sure. You remind me of someone.
You are?
Army of the Confederacy, Sergeant. Jeb Stuart's Cavalry. We fought most anywhere.
Battle Wilderness. We were there. I know you were. Would the name Thorpe mean anything to you?
Well, it sure would. The colonel commanding the troops on our left flank. Seen him once with Jeb, but... Oh, wait. That's who you remind me of.
That was who I am. I was.
Well, you were a colonel then.
Yeah, in the wrong army. One that lost. After war, I did the only thing I could, join the other army.
Using the name of Matson, why?
Oh, I guess I thought I'd fool him. Army life was the only life I knew. I never fooled anybody.
Colonel Thorpe, a sergeant?
I was lucky to get that high. You wondered why I was sent out here on a mission with a handful of kids?
I did.
Now, the answer's easy. They don't want me at Fort Flagg. They don't expect me to accomplish my job to get back. I'm going to.
Well, I sure hope that...
It's not enough. I need more than hope. I need soldiers. I need even one soldier to give me a fight chance.
Well, Colonel, could I be that soldier?
I'd be honored. Won't just keep it silent, will you?
Yes, sir.
We'll be riding with you for another 2 or 3 miles, and we'll split off the canyon.
Well, when you do, I'll be riding with you.
Accident, but most likely it was those raiders Matson was talking about.
What happened?
Anne! Stay here.
No!
Boy.
One thing I miss is my daughter. She had a voice people went along with.
I didn't think you were a music connoisseur.
I ain't. What I meant was, when Melissa started to sing, people stopped and listened. In West Texas, you're talking about.
Major?
Sergeant?
All right, Jenkins, make a report.
Yes, sir. There's a cattle drive not more than 5 miles from here, sir.
We're not at war with cattle.
Yes, sir, but there's a detail of Union cavalry with them cattle, sir.
Sergeant, muster the men.
Yes, sir.
Well, it'll be a while before you finish the game, Mr. Perky.
If we ever do.
Ranch burned down years ago.
Years ago? How do you know?
Condition the woods in, dried out, other things. But are you sure that's your father's ranch?
Well, of course I'm sure.
There were things to indicate it belonged to a man named Perky.
Well, that's understandable. Miss Danvers' real name is Melissa Perky.
Does it mean anything about my father?
I don't know. Except for one thing, there wasn't any sign of a body around.
Would there be after all this time?
Well, if raiders had burned the place down, they wouldn't bother to bury anyone.
Well, maybe he's still alive then.
It's possible. The thing to do is check with the nearest towns. They might have some information. We'll get back to the drive, check with Pete, send him out to any towns around.
You really think he might have got away?
Till I find out otherwise.
You men think you're good soldiers. Think it's been hard waiting here all this time. Think I've been waiting alone? I'm here to wait this over. The Yankees have been sighted headed this way. They're escorting a cattle drive. We don't know whether the herd's a decoy or not. Our orders are to hold Boho Canyon at all costs. The Yankees' mission is to attack us. We'll be ready for it. Sergeant? Fire action.
Yes, sir.
Jenkins, come with me.
Aye, men. Heard what the major said. There's Yankees on the way. Now let's get ready. You six men, over on the field pit. You four men, on the left flank. Right over here on the right flank. You two over here. Come on, move!
Plan on going hunting, Jim?
staying up there playing it safe, keeping us pinned down, waiting for night to rush us. She led these kids into a trap.
You couldn't know what was in there.
Firing by order of cannon. If I didn't know better, I'd say it was a military force we're up against.
How could it be?
The drovers! Go report to the sergeant. Hurry up on the devil.
Sergeant, the drovers! Oh, that'll make a difference.
Not if they get bottled up in the canyon. Head them off, Quince. Tell them to wait outside.
Yes. Mr. Favor, Colonel, I'm Sergeant Matson. Raiders got him pinned down.
They're not raiders. Mr. Berg here came from a camp up there. It's a military camp.
Huh? Company of Confederate soldiers up there. Soldiers that don't know the wars. Well, that don't make sense. Still fighting for the South after all this time? Well, the whole world knows we lost the war. I was with them all this time. I was hoping the war was over, but I didn't know. Well, they didn't act like Confederate soldiers, raiding the countryside. Major Anderson called it requisition. Well, why didn't the requisitioners tell them then? The Major never let anybody close enough to him to tell him anything. I don't think he wanted to know.
Look, you better get that information to the sergeant. Find out what he wants to do.
Yes, boss. Good to see you. Up the colonel. There come Confederate soldiers.
What are you talking about?
A prisoner escaped, told Mr. Favor. A company of Confederate soldiers. They don't know the war's over.
It must be true. It would explain the cannon. There's only one thing to do. We need a piece of white cloth.
I got this.
Hide on.
Cease fire!
Cease fire!
One of them is coming up the slope with a flag of truce.
We can't let him get any closer, whatever he wants. Have some of the men fire in front of him.
Yes, sir. Fletcher, all right.
Fire one round front of the enemy soldiers approaching our camp.
Major, he ain't stopping.
Get him for you. Good, sir.
Hold your fire.
He was approaching under a flag of truce. Sergeant, come with me.
You're out, soldier. Okay, get up here. Major, this is Colonel Thump. I served under him the first year of the war.
Ridiculous. No Confederate officer be wearing a uniform of a Union soldier?
No more. Union soldier. Major.
I'm glad you're not dead. I intend to have the man who shot you court-martialed.
No more Union soldiers, Major. No more Union army.
You mean they surrendered?
No. We did.
Just a temporary setback.
Major, General Robert E. Lee surrendered to General Grant at Appomattox, April 65.
1865? General Lee surrendered?
Yes. Would you mind getting me some medical attention?
Come on, Colonel. I'll help you up. That's it. Nice and easy now. Nice and easy.
belongs to you and your men, Major. It flew longer than any other Confederate flag.
And I take it we're prisoners.
No more prisoners. The war's over. We're to get a Fort Flag for your honorable discharge. They're going home.
Home? Dismantle camp, Sergeant. Get the men ready to move out.
Yes, sir.
I'm in full on. Get your personal things.
Ready.
Mr. Pickey, I don't know what to say.
I'm going to miss our check again, Major.
Have those greenhorns hold up under fire. Greenhorns? Mr. Faber, you're talking about soldiers.
It's been a long time, Mr. Faber. Kind of anxious to see my daughter again.
So am I.
We were so busy talking, forgot to thank you for that wonderful welcome home dinner you cooked.
Welcome home dinner? I thought that was our everyday stew.
Will you shut your flat mouth?
Excuse me, Paul. There's something I have to attend to.
Well, I suppose you'll be fixing up your ranch again.
I'll have to try city living. My daughter wants me to live in Philadelphia with her.
Well, good luck, Mr. Perky.
Thank you, Marty.
Did you rush things a bit, Mr. Hoyt?
I'm not rushing anything. We're ready to move out.
Yeah? Well, maybe not all of you.
I'm going home now with Pa and Nelson. I don't want to go.
Yeah, but I'm a trail boss.
Trail has to end sometime.
Yeah. In October.
October.
Well, good luck to you, Mr. Faber.
But you,
Mr. Faber.
She might not be seen in Philadelphia time you finish your job. Won't let her reach you.
Cattlemen's Association civilians are. Thanks. Depending on where you come from, you call steers brush splitters, cactus boomers, critters, rawhides, scalawags, or vacas. The drovers whose job it is to get them where they're going call them beeves. I'm one of those drovers. We've been pushing this herd for almost 500 miles, and it's still nearly twice that to Sedalia, Missouri. My name's Gil Faber, trail boss.
Plenty of grass and water.
Hey, feet.
Funny looking wagons.
Especially out here. Seen them before, but usually there was a big wagon train heading west.
Maybe they took the wrong turn.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That sure is a strange sight.
Last time I seen Jasper's dressed like that driving. They're driving a hearse.
You and your flat mouth.
They was.
Main thing, if you want a good rope, is start with a skinny cow. Once died in poverty. That way you don't get hide full of fat. Nothing but glue. That's what you want. Anything stirring?
Nothing but the wind and the wolves.
Want me to fix something to eat?
No. Where's Mushy?
Send him down the stream to do the dishes. Has been gone an awful long time, though.
Maybe he fell in.
Boy, you ever seen anything like that before, Mush?
I ain't even sure I'm seeing it now.
Consommé is excellent, François.
Merci, monsieur. But the consommé was better in Louisiana. How many did we serve for dinner? 60? 80?
Yes, but that was before the war. Everything was bad then. Jonah, you think I made a mistake?
It is not for me to say, sir.
Oh, yes. I should not have come to America. I should not have brought money with me. I should not have put my money on a losing cause.
Yes, sir.
You obeyed your heart, monsieur. That is what counts.
I don't expect any visitors.
You don't have to announce me.
Mrs. Bradley.
Sit down. Are you surprised that I'd follow you? I still have that letter, Mr. Laurier.
Why don't you let me see it then?
And have you destroy it? The only evidence there is that my husband is not dead.
But we were over all that before.
Yes. Your way.
What other way is there?
A new way. Mine.
And what is that way?
When I came to you in San Antonio...
Mrs. Bradley, you have no right to believe that your husband is alive. It is 4 years now that I sent him and my prisoners of war back to the Union Army.
I believed you then.
Now you don't believe me.
I believe your prisoners never reached the Union Army.
But you're right, Mrs. Bradley. They never did reach them. But neither did my men that guarded them. You see, there were still some Southern units around that never did accept surrender. They turned into raiders. And I believe they were the ones that attacked and killed him.
I believed you before. Now I know better.
Better.
Better get a good night's sleep. Not back in 3 days, but the Federals at Fort Sucker know all about it.
Move. Right. All right, move them out, Wish.
What are you doing with them rings?
I was calling for it.
Look, Mr. Summers, still go back to Fort Stockton and be safe there. And I could still go into the valley and find out what we can.
You won't get very far.
You sure you want to go?
I'm sure I don't want to go, but let's go. I know it's the only way in.
You're right. Half his men could hold up army. Well, no use waiting.
Lookout post.
Is that bad aim or a woman?
Oh, they want us to stop and wait. Wait here.
Keep an eye out. I'll find out what they want.
Job asking, mister.
I don't mind that, but I'll do my answering to Mr. Laurier.
I'll take your guns. I said, I'll take your guns. Nice to have you back, Mr. Summers. This way.
This way.
It's nice to see you again, Mr. Fibber. You too, Mr. Summers. Mr. Garrett, give those guns back to my guests. And help Mr. Summers from his horse.
You'll kill me. Kill me.
Do I look like a violent man to you?
Why, no, Mr. Laurier.
Take Mr. Summers to his room.
They'll kill me.
They'll kill me, I tell you. They'll beat me to death.
Poor Mr. Summers, he's very sick. Will you join me, gentlemen?
Oh, it's Pete Nolan, our scout, Miss Laurier.
Glad to meet you, sir.
Glad to meet you, Mr. Laurier.
Also, a nice welcome drink for our visitors.
Oui, monsieur.
Gentlemen, have a seat. If you don't mind, what exactly did poor Mr. Summers tell you?
Well, he had quite a fantastic tale to tell us. Couldn't completely discount it because of the condition that he was in. He said that you were keeping prisoners here, forcing them to work as slaves, and that they were all Union officers who had been prisoners of war.
Mr. Summers is telling the truth.
Mean you are keeping prisoners here?
No, only one, Mr. Summers himself.
Why him?
I have a brother, Mr. Favor. He fought with me on the side of the Confederacy. Soon as the news of the war reached France, he joined me. During the last year of the war, he was captured. He's still a prisoner in Washington.
Why would they still be holding him?
As a hostage.
Hostage for what?
For me. I'm very honored that you see they consider me what they call a very important war criminal. They would very much like to lay their hands upon me.
Well, what good is holding Mr. Summers going to do you?
Oh, I have something to offer in return for my brother's freedom. Mr. Summers is a very important man himself. He was a brevet general. Tell me, sir, why did you bring Mr. Summers back to me?
Well, I fought for the South myself. I couldn't believe that a Southern officer was capable of what Mr. Summers accused him of. I wanted to give you every chance to explain.
Thank you, sir. Well, now you've heard my explanation. What are you going to do?
Now, there's nothing to do. Forget the whole thing. Get back to our herd. Besides, I would hate to see such an important man falling into the hands of Yankees.
Thank you again, gentlemen. Oh, here are your refreshments. By the way, the Sedalia Trail is quite some distance away from here. You must be tired. I'd like you to have dinner with me, and I'd like you to rest for the night here.
I'm afraid we don't have time for that.
I insist, please.
Well, in that case, thank you.
Does any one of you play chess?
Mr. Faber's pretty good.
Some.
Well, then we might have a nice little game tonight, huh?
Fine.
Upon occasion, brandy is better before dinner than after.
He's my overseer.
Could I see you alone, Mr. Loyer?
Of course. Will you excuse me, please?
I imagine this must be quite a change for you, living out here after Louisiana.
It's lonely.
I imagine that, especially since your brother's gone.
I don't have a brother.
I'm sorry, I meant since he disappeared.
I never had a brother. I'm an only child.
What's that you're making, Miss Rea?
Table linen.
What was that?
What? I'd better go to my room now.
Summers?
Good.
You see anything?
No, it's too dark.
You like my chess set, Mr. Favor?
Oh, yes. Very fine ivory.
Yes, it's beautiful. Shall we play again?
Fine.
I guess we didn't find anything. What do we do about getting back in that house?
Same way we came up.
He's not in the house.
Are you sure?
He rode out at daybreak with those two drovers to show him the plantation.
Why would he ride out with them?
To catch him. More like it, make him catch themselves.
That sounds more like him. How long do I wait?
I should be back anytime now.
I don't mean that. I mean for you.
You know I can't leave here. Not yet. You know what? You keep making me say it. If you want.
I know you never will live here. You're afraid of my father, aren't you?
Not of him. Not of anybody. I just came in to bring you some threat.
Well, children, I hope you two enjoyed yourself as much as I hope my guests enjoyed themselves.
You know, Mr. Laurie, if your cotton wasn't so scrawny, I'd have thought I was down in Louisiana somewhere.
If it weren't for a lost cause, so would I. It's short fire, but quite resilient. To think of it, a scant few years ago, there was nothing here but desolation. Now there is a plantation. From this, through this, to this, I just made $250,000.
Convince me I'm in the wrong business.
Me too.
You have enough thread, Miss Laurier?
For a week, thank you, Mr. Anderson.
Would you like to freshen up, gentlemen?
Why, yes, thanks, Miss Laurier.
Odette, the next time you need some thread, send a servant. I don't like secret meetings.
And I don't like a lot of things here.
Laurier forgot to show us one thing.
Yeah, that cotton that Summers was telling us about.
Even if you got a gin hidden away, you got to have power one kind or another to run it.
Most cotton gin run by steam, I think.
That doesn't mean burning wood. I ain't seen any smoke.
Well, you can't do it by hand.
Come in.
Dinner is to be served in a few minutes, messieurs. I have brought you enough water.
Oh, sure, I'm fine.
Merci.
Merci.
Enough water. Remember the stream we ran across last night?
Yeah.
I know if you need power, you can run a mill that way, so...
So why not a cotton gin?
Dammed up here to feed that flume over there.
Thank you.
Where there's prisoners.
Yeah. Let's get a better look.
Wait a minute. Get closer to them caves, it'll be easier.
Well, guards won't be looking for anybody to come into the caves. He'll just be trying to stop them from leaving. And we can manage it.
I'm sure right.